Welcome back, everybody, and today I'm with EnterpriseE, and he is in Sandbag Shuttle, and we are going to be taking a look at the Sovereign class, which he's brought to me. This is obviously too large to enter a normal lineup review. Tonight would normally be the lineup, but obviously I wanted to take a quick look at some of these larger ships. You get a lot of people who can't come to lineups, so we're going to take a quick look around the top side first. And obviously we'll start at the saucer, so yeah, if you want to go in close, that's it, and then I'll follow you around.
Shall I just talk about it as I'm going?
Yeah, please do. Obviously I can see you got the pentas and the tetras in.
Yeah, and you see those yellow bits?
Yep.
They're meant to represent the actual thruster exhaust that they have on pretty much every single Federation ship.
Right, right.
I've actually got thrusters in there.
Haha, nice. Thrusters have thrusters. It's legit.
Yeah, you can see them if you look closely.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I've got four sets of those on the saucer section.
Yeah.
Pentas and tetras literally everywhere possible.
Yeah, it's very nice.
Which Raven himself said looked pretty good.
Yeah,
you can see all the crew quarters from out here.
Yeah. Through the windows, so that.
Yeah, and you can see the observation decks on the top of the ship. Right there.
I think I'm gonna have to turn Bloom off when I go inside.
Oh, right. Because I've got quite a lot of lighting.
It just suddenly got really bright. Yeah, definitely. Have to
That's deck two. Which I will be going inside in a little bit. I've got the phaser strips comprised of antimatter cannon arrays. All of them function fine. All of them put together gives me 12,000 DPS at the moment. There's also the impulse engines in the right place, as well as the main shuttle bay. A load of lights on the side, just to illuminate it slightly. Also, there's a little something on the back end I've kind of sneaked in.
Where are you?
Back end of the ship.
Just looking at that warmness.
See this bit
cell
down here?
That warmness cell is really nice.
You see this bit with the white light cross?
Yeah, come down.
Ships can dock on that and I can just tow them along.
Oh, I see what you've done. So it's a roleplay dock.
It's meant to be as if I'm using a tractor beam to pull someone along.
It's like a tractor beam, yeah, yeah.
And believe me, I have tried it out as Lego 8-bit on the server knows.
Very nice.
Because just before he joined my faction, his ship had next to no engines, so I kind of gave him a ride. So yeah, there's not too much else on the outside. Apart from one or two other bits on the underside of the saucer section, which I'll show you at the end. Well, there's the deflector dish as well.
Yeah. It's coming up under
which
the
saucer. Which does have functioning systems, which I'll show you from the inside.
Yeah. Oh, I've got a chunk error. Don't worry, it's okay.
Well, if you come to where I am now, you'll see the entrance to one of the cargo bays underneath the saucer section.
Hang on a sec, coming to you.
I'm underneath. Right here.
Yeah.
They're in the exact locations they should be in.
Oh, I see. Hang on, let me have a look. Nice.
I thought that'd be a nice touch.
Yeah, it's cool.
And also the detailing here.
Yeah.
That's actually got shielding hidden below it.
Oh, nice.
With those little lines, there's with 250 blocks of shielding under those, gave me about 20k shielding.
So where does this ship actually come from? I forget.
Star Trek. From Next Generation films after Generations.
Ah, it's from the Next Generation films. Right, right, right.
Yeah. From First Contact all the way through to Nemesis.
Oh yeah, it's that one. Yeah, I remember that one. Cool looking ship.
And there is an interior to the warp nacelles, but I'll show you those at the end.
Yeah, cool. All right, well, let's head on inside then, shall we?
We'll head on in through this shuttle bay here.
Is there a dock?
You can use that. I'll just park this here for now.
Okay. I'll leave my chair in the hangar. Right, let's go. You lead the way. I'm going to do
right,
a full
tour.
There's
two cargo bays here.
So we've got a cargo bay.
Same on the other side.
Beautiful. Oh, have I got gravity?
Right here.
Oh. You know what that means. Hey.
Well, yeah.
I'm in. Let's go.
All right, I'll take you through to main engineering.
Nice.
One warp core.
Oh, I'm just going to turn off my bloom.
Okay. I do have a warp core injection patch as well.
There we go. I have actually got a mod, guys. Sorry. My bloom is modded. So, as you can see, it's not glowing and overpowered white now. So, onward. I actually prefer it. It gives it a nice sci-fi feel, but it, with a light-coloured interior, it doesn't work as well.
Right. I'll take you down to the bottom of my engineering so I can show you a little hidden feature.
Okay, let's go. Oh, watch over the warp core.
You see those doors?
Yeah. Oh.
Ejection hatch.
No. Are you going to eject the warp core?
I wish I could.
But only it, because you
know,
need a massive...
You know that mechanic you told me about?
The breakaway. Yeah, you could then, couldn't you? You could have one block attaching it at the top and shoot it away
or
something.
That's
what
I'm thinking.
Yeah, yeah.
And if I just fill it with a load of... disintegrator explosives.
I mean, if you made this, you could do it with the normal thing, but you'd have to build it off a dock at the top, and then you'd have to make this thing really wide as well. You know,
yeah, but that'd just be awkward.
Yeah, right. What else have we got? Yeah, you don't want to fall down there, mate. Yep.
I'll take it to deflector control, which is right here.
Oh, look at this! Outstanding.
As you can see, load of systems built in.
Oh wow, it's all functional. So deflector control actually has a functioning deflector. I'm impressed.
Exactly.
So what is that?
Repair, salvage, power drain, power supply.
Everything. Everything that you could want. All in one place.
I've even got pulsators hidden elsewhere in the ship.
And you've got basic chairs. What have we got up here? Oh, more stuff.
Two-tiered control room.
Nice. Okay, let's go onward, sir.
Right, for this next bit, you'll need to come out of gravity temporarily.
Oh dear. Okay. Oh, just it's for the lift. Yeah.
I'll show you the control room here because it's right here. I have it on a much larger scale on the main shuttle bay. But a nice little control area.
Shuttle bay control.
I mean, just this bit alone, the RP possibilities are endless.
Yeah, definitely. This looks very nice. Carry on.
Alright, I'll take into the primary hull now.
Uh-oh. It's all good.
Yeah, for this corridor area here, I prefer to stay in outside of gravity to make it easier.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah, but then you go out of sync. I don't know where you are. Oh, you're up there now.
Up here.
Up we go. In gravity again.
Oh, shucks. I forgot to put gravity units here.
It's all right. I'm already in it.
Right, we've got two sick bays, one on the other side.
Oh, whoops, I went the wrong way. Oh, you're there you are.
Yeah, those corridors just go around the outer edge. There's no rooms on the outer edge.
That's alright. Right, so what have we got?
Two sick bays.
Meh, haha, sick bays.
It does the job.
Contour wall design. What's that? Crystal and a light switched off?
Yep.
Is the light? Is that a light?
Yeah, plex light.
Oh, cool.
Next up will be the main core room.
And we're back.
Here's where all the systems are actually controlled from.
There we go. Ooh. Tab F6 for the win. Thank you, schema.
Emphasis on the actually part of it, as I'll be demonstrating when we get up to deck one.
Nice weapon system, dude. Enough weapons. Quality. What's next?
There's an observation port right here. It may look like you only see hull dead ahead, but you need to look down from the window. If I'm above something, you get a really nice view.
Well, I know what you mean, yeah. Oh, yeah, there's a planet down there.
Yeah, there is no.
A couple of them. Right. Where to next? That's the observation.
I'll take you up a deck next.
It really does look better when you're in gravity.
I'll be in gravity in a moment.
Alright.
Oops, wrong one. There's one in here that does have gravity.
Oh, what? What? Another turbo lift?
Right here.
You have so many turbo lifts.
Here's the
ODA. You should put a turbo lift in one of your turbo lifts. Right.
Right, this is what's known as the ODN core on the Sovereign class.
Okay.
As you can see, it's on the outside, it's just power supply.
Yep, yep.
But if you press R on it, you can see just how much power generally this thing has.
No. No, I cannot.
Oh, that's weird. I'll show you at the end.
Never mind. So, doesn't matter anyway. It's all good. You got power gen, I'm sure.
This is one room you'll like.
Ooh.
Brig. This thing does have 1.3 million shielding.
Have you got can you make a GIF? Just close.
I don't know how to, honestly.
Close the door. Close the door. Look over here, right? And get a nice angle on it and like have you got a pause and break key on your keyboard?
I do.
Just stand still and push that button now.
What, just push and hold?
Yeah, just push it once. Tell me you're doing it now.
Yep, doing it now.
Okay, I'll do. Press it again.
Done.
Nice. Right, now onwards. Yeah, cool brig.
Right, next is the forward observation post. And the conference room all in one.
Ooh.
This is where I was giving Slate a ride earlier. He was just in here looking out the window.
Nice. I really like the interiors. It's very clean, but it's also very colourful. I like the colour. Sometimes it's a bit boring.
Yeah, I kept it nice and bright.
Yeah, it's really nice. You've got like checkers down, and you've got some colours using crystal and lights, but it's blending together, which is really nice. Look at this. The chairs, they're cool chairs. All right.
They do the job.
You've got to be able to get over him with one leg, though.
Mm.
Like Riker.
Yeah.
So they can't be too big. Everyone knows Star Trek chairs are small.
Yeah, I've just done what I can with the space I have. There are some crew quarters on this deck.
Mm-hmm.
If I remember rightly.
Yeah.
Yep, right at the end of this corridor, on the left. There is gravity in each room, like a natural gravity unit. And a nice view out the window.
Crew quarters and a room. Just need someone to come in here and, you know, make the cat their home. Make, you know.
Yeah, earlier today I was looking at an NPC shop I know about to see if I could buy some NPCs to just scour around. But there was one slight problem. The NPC who was selling them seems to have been killed.
Oh dear. Yeah, that happens. It's a thing.
Yeah. Yeah, as you can see on the roof of the corridor, you can see it slopes to make it a bit more smooth. You'll need to come out of gravity here.
Nice. As we stumble through the corridors of Sovereign.
Yeah.
Onward we go.
More crew quarters.
Mm-hmm. More crew quarters.
So I could easily house a few people.
Oh, yeah. It's just a shame no one else lives here, you know?
At the moment.
Yeah.
There's an upper area here for the shuttle bay.
Nice shuttle. See, that's more like it. Let me have a look at this shuttle.
That's my general class 2 shuttlecraft.
Aha! What do you know about shuttles? There you go.
Looks like a proper Star Trek shuttle, doesn't it?
It does.
And that one does have some weapons hidden inside it.
Faction control. Oh well.
If you want to look inside, I can open the door.
No, no, it's fine. I can look through the window. Can look through the window. It's very nice. I like that you put the AMCs on the inside.
You can just about see the control room.
The what?
Up here.
This is a much bigger hangar than you think.
You could easily fit 3 Class 2 shuttles, and each one is 12 meters in length. And if you wanted to walk on the hull, that's easy enough to do. Then just back to the Odin core again, but not much else on this deck. I'll take you to the main lift.
Oh, where'd you go? You disappeared. Oh, panic. Oh, there you are. There you are. I'm with you. Going up?
You may want to come out of the gravity for this bit.
I thought so. Yeah, up. Nice. Up is good. So what have we got? We got, control. More hangar control.
Yeah, main shuttle bay control room.
Nice. What other gems do you have in store for me?
Well, up here you can get to the rain bridge.
Oh, that captain's chair. You didn't let me down, did you? Look at that. Look, everyone else gets just a little thing in the captain's chair. You have the bridge. Oh, legit. That looks great.
I'm glad you like it.
Screenshot.
And if you look at the actual consoles, you can see actual computers there. But they don't control any systems at all.
Decoys. Oh, yeah, yeah. Decoy computers.
Oh, I need to get this thing out of the faction, unfortunately.
Oh, okay.
Briefing room.
Nice, for meetings and such.
Yep.
Discussions with dignitaries and so on. Beautiful. It's just like the show.
Yeah, and the view outside is quite nice.
Oh, yeah, it is. Get a nice view of the warp nacelles. Love it. Right. What's next?
I'll start making my way back downstairs because I'm going to go into the shelter bay. Then I'm going to take you inside the nacelles.
Okay. I'm glad I got you with me. I never would have known to go that way.
Hmm.
Are we going to fly there in the shuttle?
Why not?
Ha ha ha! Where's the gravity block? Oh, nice.
I'll just take it out the faction quickly.
Okay.
Try now.
Yeah, I'm good. Oh boy. I'm going to get a view out the back as we exit the hangar. Note that my ship isn't in this hangar.
Yeah, on the way back I'll take you back to your ship.
Cool. Whoa-hey! This is epic.
We're at the nacelles now.
Okay, right, hang on. Spacewalk time.
What do you mean?
Woo, I'm getting out. Spacewalk! Nice. I love it. We were up there, now we're here. Beautiful.
Have a look.
That was smooth. Oh! Warp drive, go! That's really cool.
My normal warp coil design?
Yeah. It's got a real optical effect.
Yeah, but I've got something else hidden in here.
It's the negative space. What?
Come to where I am and
look
exactly
where I'm
looking.
It's like the latest catchphrase. What? Look, what, come to where?
You look here, you'll see there's a block that's not a thruster.
What, you? What is that?
Pulsator.
Really?
Yep. At the end of the video, I'll show you how it actually...
I was wondering what those blocks were. Okay, cool. Yeah, that's really cool. All right,
there isn't too much else to show, to be honest.
That's alright. Take me to the top hangar where my chair is. And,
ready?
I'll get the... Yeah, I've got the rear view. I'm trying not to stand on the wedge because sometimes you fall off. Nice, smooth.
Right, I'll go back to the main shuttle bay, then I'll quickly show you what this thing can do.
Okay.
But with the actual external details and the internal ones, that's about it.
So there we go. That is the EnterpriseE by EnterpriseE.
I'm ready to show you whenever you are.
Sovereign class. Oh, he's firing the main guns. Well, one of them.
That's the AMCs.
That's AMCs.
One of the missiles.
Yep.
And if you look around where the secondary hull is, you saw some come out from there.
No, I didn't.
That's weird.
Maybe there's a bit of lag.
Give me a few moments and
I'll
recharge.
Yeah, I'll just go over the other side. Maybe I'm in a different sector over there.
Maybe. If you fly below the ship, you'll be able to see it.
Alright.
Yeah, you'll be safe there.
Go for it.
I just fired them.
I'm not seeing them. That's alright, maybe it's just... Oh wait, hang on, the sector just changed. I think you're on a sector boundary, so try it now.
I'll reverse slightly to be on the safe side.
Yeah, me too. Right, try it now. There we go. Missiles!
And now for the main bit I wanted to show you. Fly between the nacelles and look at just one of them.
Fly between them and look at one.
Just look at the nacelles.
Yeah, I'm looking at one of them.
Did you see the pulsator effect?
No, I didn't.
That's weird. Just give it a few moments to recharge. I would like to mention this ship is pretty quick for its size. I mean, it was able to tow a ship about half the size of it easily, and it didn't actually affect the thrust of it much at all.
Yeah.
Right, you looking?
Yep. Oh, there they are. There's a little pulse at the beginning. Yep. So I take it you drop that as you accelerate away, and it just leaves a little thing in the... And
it makes it look like I've gone to warp.
It runs down the thing like, yeah, so I like that. You've built in your own warp effect, and it just has a high thrust. Therefore, it goes fast when you push the button.
Yeah, I mean, like the acceleration on this is not, it's not even funny how fast it is.
Because from a distance, it looks really good. I'm going to do a couple of passes like this.
Go for it.
Because, like, from here, the ridges sort of blend into, you know, just detail. They just blend into a texture. And you wouldn't, you know, you would be forgiven if you didn't think it was all little blocks and wedges.
Because wedging a thing like this is not easy. But I've done a good job of it, I think. But believe me, the wedging and penters and stuff took a while.
Oh, I believe you. You're preaching to the choir, man.
Yeah, but it definitely works. I mean, even with the support pylons for the main engines, I've hidden shielding in there. Because the bits that are 3 blocks thick, I've actually hollowed that out and put shielding in there. So overall, this thing has 1.325 million shielding, 54.9k thrust, 3.3k mass. No, 33.4k, I mean. And power storage of over 11 million produces 1.9 million a second. Generally, it's sufficient. I'll quickly get to the main shuttle bay and make sure that shuttle I was in originally is actually docked.
Beautiful, man.
Would you like me to show you it, what, like, going away at high speed at the end of this?
Yeah.
Just give me a moment to get to this shuttle actually docked.
Sure.
Good thing I know my way around this ship like the back of my hand.
Indeed.
Because I know people get lost in these things easy. I just wish there was like a signposting mechanic for inside ships. We'd avoid issues like that actually happening. Oh, the shuttle's now outside for some reason. Right, you ready?
Hang on.
mean, the design of this is fairly sleek from what I've seen.
Yeah. Okay, man. Go for it.
And it's already at max speed.
Just like that. Didn't take long.
And it stops pretty quickly as well.
I got an idea. Hang on. Right. Don't move. Okay. Oh. And just full speed.
Already doing it.